Are you running my bed level tests and having problems with certain corners not leveling? It may not be your fault. It may be something underneath the bed. I'll explain it all on today's Filament Friday. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. PCBWay 3D Printing Services. Filament Friday is also brought to you by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. I had this problem on one of my Ender 3 V2s. I have two of them. One of them leveled beautifully, but this one always gave me problems. I could never get that corner to level properly. And then I found it. When I pulled the bed back, the screw was slipping, but only in one direction, so I could adjust it a little bit, but then I would lose it if I turned it the other way. So it was frustrating. I had to get rid of this. So as a quick fix, what I did is I took the screw out, and I just roughed up that screw with the side cutters. I just cut little grooves in it, very, very crude, just to see if this would allow me to level the bed. And it seemed to work. The screw was not turning. I knew this wasn't a permanent fix, but it was something I wanted to try. And look at this, beautiful level. I got this thing to level perfectly, but now I want to fix it permanently. So I took all the knobs off and lifted the bed off. Now I did think about just using some super glue and gluing the screws down or using some epoxy, but metal to metal like that, I wasn't sure how well that would hold. I also thought maybe I want to remove these screws at some point and this would make it a lot tougher. I decided to put a nut on the screws to hold them in place. They're an M4 screw. Now this is a kit I recommend. I bought this a long time ago. It's so handy to have around the shop when you're working on these printers. I tightened up the nut, but then I started to worry about it rubbing against the traces on the board over time. I didn't want this thing shorting anything out. So I went and got some nylon washers, a little thicker than I wanted, but then I put the nut on top of that so the thing is insulated. And I still had enough screw left for the spring, so that's what I decided to use. Now there is another option. Some people have used these stiffer springs. They're yellow springs you can get, and they're a lot stiffer than the stock Creality springs. And so they'll hold that screw tighter when they're tightened down. Now actually my CR10, my CR10 Mini, use these springs, but they're taller. They're much taller. The ones I showed you for the Ender 3 are shorter. They match the height of the stock spring. Now I did buy a set of those springs, but they didn't arrive in time to make this video. So I took the ones I had, cut them down to the same height. But then in doing this, I decided I wanted to see if I could get those stock springs to work better. So that's what I chose to use. With all this, I'm going to have to readjust my Z-stop. I get a lot of questions on this from people. They say I can't adjust my Z-stop down far enough. Well, that's because there's this little knob on the bracket. It's not handy. There's no reason to keep it on there. So I just use my clippers and I just cut that thing off. Now it gives me a full range of motion. I'm going to tighten it up with the T-nuts anyway. So now I have full range of motion. I can go as high or as low as I want and then just tighten the screws exactly in the position where I want this thing to be. Now I shoot for some squish. This is what I ended up with. So I had to readjust my Z-stop several times. But I was able to get the bed to level in each corner, which is my procedure that I showed in a previous video. And then I ran the print test, and here it is. It came out beautifully. So this was clearly working. And I also occasionally pop the bed off now just to make sure they're holding, and they're holding in place. Now, if you're watching all this and you don't want to fool with a 3D printer anymore, or you have some really advanced prints, check out PCBWay. They offer FDM, vacuum casting, select laser melting, digital light processing, stereolithography, and selective laser sintering. And if you don't know what these are, they explain all that on their website. And you can send them a file, they'll quote it for you, and they have all the advanced features. Plus, they explain the advantages or disadvantages if you aren't familiar with it. So if you have a 3D file that you need professionally printed, or it's something that you're really having difficulty printing on your Ender 3, maybe check out pcbway.com/rapid-prototyping/3D-printing. Maybe they can help you out. I'll put a link to this in the description below. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the videos that are popping up. And if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.